Did you catch the bar where he said body shape like a dollar sign?
I mean, Olamide wouldn't stop being Olamide even on the Gentleman album. Welcome to this episode of the Chillhop Vibes. In this episode, we'll be talking about the new Olamide album, the UY Scuti. I'm here with Big Slim and Bhydemi. And we're about to shut it down. Slim, I know you, you have been listening to this album since Olamide released the album.
Yeah.
What is your, what is your overall take on the album? I mean, how did you feel when you heard this album for the first time?
I think listening to his old album, the Cap DM, and it was like a very commercialized album as well. Featured a lot of singers, did a song with Phyno. But it was almost like I'm the king now. I don't have to do like the street thing that we know, or the street music that we know Olamide for. So it changed the vibe to like the king. And then with UY Scuti, I think he embraced the growth of being the CEO, the owner of a label, and just showing people like, all right, now I can relax and do music the way I like. And like, we can see the evolution and then see the growth as well, right? With this album, I think he just like found his own pocket and just gave us like dancehall and like a nice vibe. No pun intended, or all pun intended. just give us all the vibes. And I think it's been the transition from Cap DM. And I think this is his 11th studio album.
Yeah, right? Exactly.
So, I mean, like, imagine as an artist, if your CEO is working as hard as this guy, man. You have no excuse, I swear.
Exactly. You don't have any, there's no hiding place for you
at all, man.
Because he's leading with example, and he's not also trying to overshadow his upcoming talents as well. Yeah, I mean, like, also I feel very much like what you have said. I kind of also like have seen like how Olamide has kind of like evolved as, you know, not just like the street guy that everybody knew him as, you know, and kind of became like, you know, this guy who's like basically just chilled and just allowing, you know, just dropping vibes. He's dictating his new rules. He's not like, you know, trying to compete with anybody. He's on his own lane and doing his own competition on himself.
Yeah,
I think it's kind of important from, you know, an artist. I mean, from, you know, like when you see like the fact that Olamide is like has released so much music, and usually in the music game, it's like everybody's trying to listen to the new hot thing, and then he's been able to like, you know, evolve himself, and you know, like not just fade off or fall off with the, you know, entrance of like, you know, the younger talent, and he's been able to reinvent himself. This is like really, really massive.
Exactly. And with this one as well, right, it's like 10 songs, and like knowing how the market works right now and knowing like the attention span of the listeners is not there anymore, so you cannot give them those 21 songs like before. And also like with this one, what I really do appreciate is working with like new talents like Fave, Jado, you know, some new people, just bring them to light, which I think is not really new to him though. Like he's always like but at that time he's always like worked with new artists in his own label, but at this time he just like did like great magic. And this song, the album is really like cohesive. I know we'll break down into it as well. It's luxurious to me. I mean, like compared to his own body of work, it's just poised and just like really good. And I would like us to also like, I think many people listening to the album wouldn't know the name or the meaning of the album, so maybe
I mean, this was exactly my next question, like the name of the album is UY Scuti. Why, what is exactly I mean, what is the idea behind this? Because like, it's not a usual Olamide kind of, you know, naming convention. Like, you, I mean, previously, I mean, he never really followed this part. I mean, like, while I got the album and I was trying to figure out like, why UY Scuti? Yeah, yeah. And then I kind of checked and then I discovered, I mean, like, I never really heard before, like, UY Scuti is actually like the biggest, I mean, it's like the biggest discovered star.
Yeah.
So, I mean, which basically puts, like, kind of describes Olamide's place in Nigeria's, like, industry. Yeah. Do you accept that, you know, Olamide is like, you know, in this space in Nigerian music?
Yeah, most definitely I do accept that he's up there. I mean, he's been holding it down as the only rapper holding it down with Davido and Wizkid for a very long time. I mean, before Bonner came into that conversation as well and doing great as well, Olamide has been that name that like has been closing stadiums and every event that he's been holding as well. So like, he's up there, he's like a star. And like, also the way I interpreted it as well is not just for him, because we know he's a star, and like the UY Scuti also means like the biggest of all stars, like the, you know. So and also like that also changed from how he used to name his albums, you know, just a Mayweather or Man of the Streets, or you know, like now he's going scientist on everybody, man. And it's also like bringing this new art, like I said, and like Fave, for example, I think she's gonna be a star. She reminds me so much of Thames, which so I think it's also like bringing the light on those people and making those people stars as well. So of course, Olamide is in the conversation, most definitely.
I also think the same. I think it's like, I mean, you know, he's been consistent, he's like had like a very good run of albums, and I mean, it's like Olamide, we know Olamide to drop an album every year, so we know like we're gonna get it's like Father Christmas, so we're okay, gonna
twice in a year or something.
Yeah, we know we're gonna get some goodies, you know. When it comes to this guy, we get some goodies. And so this album is not like, you know, it's not really much the normal Olamide style. So the normal Olamide is like, you know, street rap and stuff like this. Did you ever think Olamide at any point before now will like go through the point where you see Olamide like becoming more like a gentleman, if I will?
no way. Like, listening to this, I was like, okay, this is a CEO, a father, someone accepting his age and be like, all right, I don't really need money from music right now, I can do what I enjoy or what I would like to listen to at this age. And yeah, I think sometimes you just have to accept it as well and be like, okay, this is what my core fans who have been following me for more than 10 years now, and they're grown, they're no longer in their 20s or probably in their 30s and want to listen to something different. So for the only single right now, I think, is Rock. Listening to the song off the album before I listened to the whole project, I did not really get it, but like listening to it as part of the body of work, I get it now, and I do enjoy it, because like I said, this is the most cohesive album that Olamide has made, to be honest. Like,
yeah, I mean, I also agree with that, because like, you know, to stand alone listen to a single at times doesn't, I mean, you can judge it,
yeah,
but then when you see the body of work, then you know how to really place it. In this case, this is a perfect case where the single outside the body of work might not really make much sense. Yeah. But then when you have the whole body of work, then you now understand, oh, now this is what I'm getting, you know, and that is really, really good. Now, what are your tracks? What are the tracks that you really, really love from this album?
Man, Need for Speed, man. The first song on the track, it's a vibe, pun intended again. It's a vibe, man. It's a vibe. The beat is just solemn. I think most of the songs in the album are really like radio friendly. You can't really pick one. And then, and also like, maybe before we talk about that, we said it's very cohesive, and one reason could also be because he worked with just one producer.
Most albums, one producer.
Exactly, with Young John, and
that Green CEO album is like mostly so sick. Most great albums in Nigeria have been like that. I can't really put it off the top of my head, but like a couple of albums that I also are really, really great also, in this kind of.
Exactly. Well, I think sometimes if you work with too much producers, your album might sound like a compilation of music. I know album is a compilation of songs, but it's not really cohesive. But I think like working with one, you can like gather everything together. Need for Speed, where he's just talking about like how he wants to also, but like the traffic of Lagos slows him down or slows you down, or you're walking one day and then someone splashes water on you while the person is driving, and then you buy a car and you do the same thing, and it's. But like the vibe is, it's as if you're traveling. It's just like you're in a trance. So I like that. And then my next second song, favorite song, is Jayla, because that's like upbeat, coming from like Need for Speed. That one I can see like that could be a single that could be played. You can do all the shaku shaku and all of that too. I think he found his pocket in this song as well, because this was where he went closest to rapping. It dropped bars one place or the other. I love the song with Fave, Pom Pom and Want. I'll combine them together. But they're different, but of course, like both of them, because she's Fave, she's still like my Fave as well. she's a star.
That's a bar. That's a bar.
Come on now, you have to chill up. those three songs. I think the song that I don't really go for would be like maybe the last song of the album. In a way, but there's a good message to it, but maybe listening to it over and over will get it. So which songs do you prefer in the album?
In the album, my favorite songs will definitely be like Need for Speed. I think like the message is quite clear and very, very, I really like songs with some kind of message. Mm-hmm. I really like that. I like rock actually, because the two things that make me like rock really, the song is kind of good, but also like the video is kind of different, right? So like it's also like that kind of bossy stuff that Olamide is like, it's not really even showing on the video. Like most Olamide's videos are really crowded. Olamide is like jumping everywhere, but Olamide is like just inside the car. Almost all through the video, like it's like shoot maybe like just maybe 10 seconds or probably 20 seconds for the whole video. Like, I like the idea of the video. It's kind of unique and different. As regards to my last, the third, there is, I kind of like Jayla, but I like the message on So Much More. So for that reason, I will say So Much More, because of the content. Basically, that's mine.
But did you catch the bar where he said body shape like a dollar sign?
Ah, I didn't. I went off my head.
Man, when I heard that, but I was like, all right, it's no longer Coke bottle. And then I was thinking about it with like the two lines. I mean,
Olamide wouldn't stop being Olamide even on the Gentleman album.
Yeah, there was still some of the songs, but yeah, if I would give like throwback or something like to criticize would be too much emphasis on maybe the love thing, but that could be space right now, right? Could be where he is right now, but I think he could have like come at it with different angles and just like talk more. But because it gets to a point, you'd be like, all right, fine, my guy, we know, we already, you did love, what else? But
I mean, this is also my, this is also a little bit of, you know, where I kind of rest on this album, because like, to be very honest, mm-hmm. my favorite songs of this album are the ones that have content. Yeah. And I feel like there's so many things to still talk about. This is only where the album falls short for me. Yeah. Like, yeah. I feel like a lot of stuff to, you know, like really, really visit. There's so many areas, but yeah.
Yeah, because listening to the song, I was thinking about you as a hip hop purist that you are. Are you sure Bhydemi will enjoy the song though? This album, but...
I feel like Olamide has dropped us bars. You know, he has like his legendary status is already cemented. Like, you know, like the Olamide can't do much wrong anymore. Like, you know, and he's also used his open the doors for like very, very like interesting acts as well. So like he's done, like, you know, it's just like someone has done like 99 right, you know, and he just does like 0.5 wrong. Exactly. Like you could just let it white go over. And to be very honest, like also, you know, the album is like, it's a different feel, and you kind of understand as well that, you know, as an artist, you have to evolve.
Of course.
Yeah, so like he has shown us so many sides of him.
Yeah.
At the moment, like if he was to show us maybe more, maybe people will not really be interested, because like, you know, if it's crazy Olamide, like we have more crazy acts now. We have Zlatan, we have guys who are like really, really okay, and Olamide can't really compete on that level anymore. Like, you know,
past that level, to be honest.
Yeah, past the level. Like, it's more of like, you know, it's more of like when you basically like, you know, keep chasing. At some point, if you want to keep like, maybe like, it's just like a programmer now, you keep chasing a new program, you know, you're trying to like learn the new language and stuff like this. At some point, you know, you can't really chase the technology. You just have to let the younger cats, like, you know, do that. And then you just create your own lane, and, you know, you capture more fans, you know, in different demography. I could imagine like some people who never listened to Olamide before might even be willing to listen to this record.
Most definitely, you're right with that, because I think he went to like the Caribbean end as well with dancehall and, you know, pop. So yeah. I don't think there's anything wrong with that, and there's nothing wrong with that, you know, because of course he's going to the UK to perform. We have a lot of like Caribbean people. Shout out to my Caribbean people. And like, so that's also good for him, for his fan base as well. So I think this would be like the first time in like Nigerian music industry where, you know, these musicians be allowed to like evolve and do something different from what we've known them for. And I think it should long may it continue. We should allow it.
Yeah, I mean, like, I think we should just allow like creativity, like irrespective of you know, how it comes, how it, like, you know, people should be able to discover new sounds. Like, yeah. I mean but we're just making this cohesive comment, and I kind of now remember like also when STC was basically trying to discover the palm wine sound, also like it was discovered making one record, and then they kind of stuck to the producer and then made like a couple of records of it. And this is like even the much more popular part of their music.
Yeah.
And like, you know, like, I mean, the whole world is even now gravitating to that side even more, which makes a lot of sense. Yeah.
If you were supposed to suggest one song to be a single, which song would you suggest?
I mean, like with Rock already a single.
Yeah, Rock is the only single in the album right now.
Yeah, the two songs that I will say. So I will say maybe Jayla, because like it's kind of dance hall, kind of has a dance hall feel. But also, I mean, like So Much More could also be a very good single, because then Olamide was, you know, glorifying, like, you know, the female gender. Mm-hmm. So this also gives me a very good feel that, like, a kind of a song like that will do very well in almost any market.
Yeah, most definitely. There's a good message to So Much More. I think most of the songs really like focused on like relationship and love and all of that, like Julie, you know. It's a really good album, and yeah, I'm here for it, man. I'm here for it. I think
so I will ask you,
yeah,
which do you prefer, the old Olamide, the new Olamide?
I think at this stage of my life, I prefer the new Olamide. At that stage of my life, I prefer the old one. So I just let the guy be who he is, man. And at least we have to allow Jay-Z to get old and give us a masterpiece with 444. So, man, I just enjoy it as they come, my guy. The Olamide we know again. He might drop another album even before the end of the year. So,
yeah. I mean, like, I think also, like, you rightly pointed out before, like, you know, the fact that the industry, I mean, the listeners, the consumers of the music now, they kind of like give the room for artists to be more creative is also very good. Because I mean, I could imagine, like, if Olamide had dropped this album like some years back, maybe a few people will, you know, like criticize that he's now singing and all this kind of stuff, you know, like the gatekeepers, people who just always be like lyrical and dropping bars. But now it's cool to at least, you know, read some kind of channels, which makes sense.
So which song should we listen to on this review today?
I will say we should listen to Rock.
Come on now, but you know, like, the voice broke already. I have to give them something else.
What do you think?
I said for Jella. Let's give them Jella.
I mean, come on.
Need for Speed. I don't know, man. Need for Speed.
I think maybe. Well, I mean, like, wouldn't be bad to listen to Jella. Yeah, I guess.
Yeah, so let's listen to Jella.
Your skills kill the rhythm and boss it. Nobody come and down in a way. This is my breath, I need to be here. Cause the way you want your body control, I'm ready now, I'm ready to stay down. But the hot code, I'm ready to stay down. Enter my heart, down into playground. Cause the way you want your body control.
Man, that was a good jam. That was a good vibe. That was a good vibe. That was a good vibe. Nice one. I really do like the song. I guess we have to rate Olamide against Olamide, right? So
I mean, like, we shouldn't rate Olamide against Olamide. So, I think we should rate this project separately, because, like, you know, stacking it up with, like, you know, map rap, you know, the bars kind of, I mean, it's just a different, like,
that's cool though, that's first of its kind. Yeah, I see your point at that. You're right. Yours are right. So how would you rate the album?
I mean, Olamide is king, it's legendary, you know, it's really, really good. But I will rate the album for a 7, actually. The reason why is I like the new sound, I like the evolution, I like the, you know, I like the creativity that he has, you know, kind of, you know, found. But I feel like there's room to make a much more masterpiece, like, out of this, like, in terms of content. So basically, like, because most of the songs have the same, they have the same
sentiment. Yeah.
And so hopefully, like, you know, he has like a much more diverse team, and this album is like a 10 over 10 for me.
I agree with you on that one. I think he can do better too and come from different angle. But yeah, I'll give it a 7.5. I like that he found his pocket and then he went with that. And then his own baritone in Julie, the way he kept mentioning Julie, man. And like, yeah, and even like the song with Phyno, the beat. And there's a particular song too that he was writing the beat so well. I cannot remember that. Yeah, I think it's the fourth song on the album. And then the way it was, or maybe it's even Jayla. I think it's Jayla. The way he was writing the beat in the second verse. Yeah, so I really do. I feel like even with like Need for Speed as a message with it, mid-tempo, just like you have to really, sometimes you have to pay so much attention to the lyrics because you are enjoying the vibe so much. Yeah, but yeah, to me it's an enjoyable album, but I agree with you too. It's coming from same angle, same sentiment, so sometimes you could just lose track of whatever it's saying and just enjoy the beats alone. But shout out to Eskiz, man. Shout out to Eskiz. Like, great body of work. Maybe we should even like review his discography, you know.
Yeah, maybe we should. I mean, at some point we will, you know, look at it, because I mean, Olamide is like, it's like enough episodes on Olamide alone.
Definitely.
But I mean, we could, you know, stack up different moments of his, you know, career, because it's like a very, very incredible art. Yeah. It's like another Mr. Incredible.
Exactly. Watch our other videos and other reviews that we did as well. And yeah. Please click on the subscribe button, click on the like button. If you've not followed us on Instagram or Twitter already, the link is below. Just click on all of that and give us a follow. I'm Big Slim.
Bhydemi.
Yeah, and we're out of here. Enjoy.